So, yesterday, I did some additional feathering on the breast, and I need to do a little bit more on the underside of the tail. I want to extend some feathers here. Make some changes here before I actually start painting. First off, I want to adjust this tail feather, these two tail feathers. So, right now, they're longer. Going to redo a few of these feathers, so I'm going to quick paint over the bottom few that I want to redo. You'll know when you get it right. And you'll be so happy when you do. I just got it right. So I'm going to come back. I'm going to come back and just clean things up with the dark brown. Because I removed a lot of incorrectly placed lines. So once this gets cleaned up, it'll be a lot more obvious what I was after. Now the first time I do this, I'm just covering the inside of the dark area of the feather, not the quill and not the light outer edge yet. I will be coming back and tinting that down, but I want to have a really good representation of the tail feathers before I tint down the lines that are creating them right now. So I've got quills and outer edges outlined. Cleans up pretty good. And you know, really painting these things is a matter of going back and forth and back and forth until you get it exactly the way you want it to be. And I think patience is one of the biggest aspects in successfully painting a bird. You have to have the patience and the diligence to go back and take care of the little things. Because, you know, that's what the judges are going to be looking at if you get to the end and they're trying to determine whether yours or another's is better. Well, here's your chance to convince them. Now, I got a couple of lines here that I want to reveal because I kind of painted over them accidentally. I don't want to lose that yet. All right. Continue on the rest of the tail, undertail here. Independence Day 2019. Kind of early in the morning. So I thought I'd pick up and get a little bit more done today before we start celebrating. Okay, so now you can see what I've done. Reinforced with the dark colors, the dark brown. I'm going to come back and just do one more light pass on all these, on the underside of these tail feathers. No. I'm going to quick tint. Must have lost a brush along the way. This will be just fine. All right. Remember yesterday I had said I would probably do this more than once when it came to tinting these dark feathers that I've laid, the feather layout into, using a contrasting color, but I want to soften that up. So I'm just tinting it down so it's not quite so harsh, but it's still there as a reference for me when I start painting in the individual barbs coming off of each of these quills that I've placed. So, the trick is not to cover it up too much. You want to lose your reference. And the same thing on these primary feathers. These upper tail coverts. Soften everything. The thing that's nice about the tinting is there are areas that when you're laying out your feather pattern with the contrasting color that come up a little bolder than some of the others. So you can come back and make those adjustments with the color you're painting on, and it won't seem so uneven. This can even everything out for you. And I'm staying away from the amber colored feathers. So I'll be coming back a little bit later and starting to paint in those diamonds on the feather detail. So you might go over with this tint in one area once, and then have to go over it twice in another area to even things out. Basically, you're just wanting to have these reference lines for painting in your barbs and quills. I haven't done quills on the scapular feathers or the primaries. It's a big brush to be taking care of some of these smaller areas, but it's still working fine, so. When you're tinting, be sure and check, you know, all the areas. Make sure you didn't miss it somewhere. Good thing I strengthened that tail. Alright. Feeling pretty good about that. Add a few more feathers to that lower, those lower tail coverts, so things aren't so uniform. Okay, I know you guys can't see this. I'd like you to, but let's see if I can clean it up in your view. Again, just like I did the dark feathers, I'll be coming back and cleaning up with the gray paint once I am sure about my layout. Okay, got that cleaned up pretty good. that. Feeling pretty good about what I got going here now. So now I can come back with the gray. And clean things up. And the smudged brown that I changed up when I added a few more feathers. Just didn't want it to look so pat. I guess is the only way to describe it. Just too perfect. Alright, so I'm gonna go with this gray. Again, only within the actual feathers. And we'll probably do this twice just to reinforce that gray and define these lines that are going to act as the outer edge shadows of each feather. Where on the dark feathers, the outer edge highlights are what's going to define the outer edge of the feathers. On the dark feathers in this bird. Because we don't see these individual feather lines, but I need the guidance to lay in my feather barbs and individual details for the feathers. So I do this, and it's pretty coarse in the very beginning, but when I come back in my next step, we'll see, because I'll tint this just like I tinted those dark feathers and the contrasting highlight defining each one of them. This is the contrasting shadow defining the light colored feathers. It's kind of doing the same thing with the side pocket feathers. I'm pretty happy with how they're laid out. So I'm not needing to add any. As they approach the front of the breast though, they do tend to get a little bit tinted with the yellow oxide. This color, the orangey. So I'll be adding that, tinting that a little bit in a little while. Thing on this side. Each time I do this, it softens up that hard line I added in contrast. And if I do it several times instead of once, each time I do it, it softens it in just a little bit more. Okay, so I'm going to take my ring off. I just felt it hit the surface. So now I'm going to tint it all. see it. The lines are still showing through as my reference. So when I looked at these white feathers of the side pockets and the upper and lower tail coverts, the darkest color in that white was this gray, this light gray that I'm initially painted this area with in my base coats, and then I came back with the contrasting dark brown, laid out my feather patterns, and now I'm coming back with that same light gray and just softening up all of these lines that I added by adding a tint. This way I still have my reference lines. I know where I'm going to paint my feathers. And I can just go ahead and place quills and start painting in barbs. Alright, I need to wash my hands. I just transferred a little bit of light paint onto the back of the bird. Alright, so that tinting is done. I've got those extra feathers added. That makes me feel better about the feather layout. It's not so uniform.